Aloha and welcome back to .NET MAUI 101. I'm your host Gerald, and in this episode we're going to talk about property triggers, which allow you to change the visual appearance of a control based on property values of that control without any code. Let's see how that works. Welcome back to .NET MAUI 101. I'm your host Gerald, and in this episode we're going to talk about property triggers. Now, before I go into that, you must know that there are multiple types of triggers in .NET MAUI. I've linked to the documentation page down below, and of course, I've got videos on all of them. And with those triggers, you can change the visual appearance based on certain criteria. So with property triggers, you can do that based on a certain property value. We're going to see that in this video. For data triggers, you also have data triggers. You can do it on a certain value in your data, so in your code behind, or from other controls, or you have multi-triggers, which can combine a couple of values. We'll see all of that in different videos. For this one, I'm going to focus on property triggers. So imagine that you have an entry, and whenever that entry is focused, you want to have it to have a different background. Maybe your designer came up with this crazy design, and to make clear to your user that a certain entry is focused, you want to have a little style option. Now, what you could do is go into your entry, and hook up the isFocused event, then you are going to write some code like, hey, now the background color should be this and that, which is not great, right? I mean, it works, whatever works is a great solution, but you can do that much prettier in XAML with property triggers. So let's go check that out. So here we are in Visual Studio 2022. I created a file new .NET MAUI project. And I already implemented the property trigger right here, but I left most of the default template as intact as possible, so you can spot the differences really easily of what I'm doing here. So basically here in the middle of the screen, you can already see the property trigger. Now this was an entry, or sorry, a label originally with the text hello world with the waving.net bot, right? And I changed that in an entry so we can have a look at that example that I just mentioned with the is focused. So we have this text, which is, you know, a default property, semantic properties, font size, horizontal options, all great. But here we have the interesting thing. So the entry is not self-closed, right? So we have this tag right here, which is closing. And then you can specify entry.triggers. So this is just a different notation in XAML for properties, right? I could also do entry.horizontal options like this, but it gets verbose really quickly, so you probably don't want to do that. But for these more complex type of properties, this is the way to go. So entry.triggers, and then we can specify one trigger in here, right? So you can have exactly one trigger as opposed to multi-triggers that we will see in another video. Then on that trigger, we have a couple of attributes. So we set the target type so it knows you know, what type this is going to be used and what properties are available here. And then you can specify the property. In this case, is focused. We'll see another property in a little bit as well. But you can do is focused, is password, is whatever. You can basically set any property of any control here. And then you can match the value right here. So whenever this is basically matched, so whenever is focused is true, or I could make this also false, then it will apply whatever is going on here. And you can have multiple setters in here. And you already know the setters from the styles and that kind of stuff. So you can do the setter for the property background color, and the value will be yellow. So what do we expect to see here? If I run this on Windows, we expect to see this entry. I think the entry is focused because it's the first entry now on the screen. It will be focused by default, and it will have a yellow background because it's focused. And whenever I get the focus off there, it will not be yellow anymore. It will go back to the original state, which is in this case a white background. So you can see the yellow background is right here. And if I click the button, the focus goes away because the focus goes to this button right here. And now it goes back to its original state. And whenever I click it again, you can see it becomes yellow. No lines of code, just some stuff in XAML to do this. Now, if you are a good XAML citizen and you don't like to have all that fluff in there, you want to do this through styles, right? We hear you, you can totally do that as well. So here, if we scroll up a little bit, I've got this style here in a comment, so let's uncomment that. And again, style, target type, entry, but you can also do style.triggers, right? So you can also have triggers in styles. Now here we have the same trigger, right? So you could just take it from here, copy it or cut it and paste it in here, and now we have the same thing. And that's also why we need that target type, right? So we could basically maybe infer it from the style here, and here obviously from the control control, it belongs to. But like this, it's like very explicit, you know what it is. And for the style, that's very useful as well. So we have this target type entry. This time I'm gonna go with property is password, right? And whenever that is true, I'm going to set the background to red. Now, obviously you can also have multiple setters here. So I can also do the border and whatnot and the font family, if that's something that you want. You can set all the things on that control to whatever you want. The thing that you want to watch out for is, of course, setting something through a style and on the control itself. That will start conflicting and not really be nice. So for this, and of course, the one last thing about the styles, this is implicit, right? Implicit styling. I also got a video on styles. Go check that out. If you want to have it on specific entries only, you have to specify the key. And then on each entry, you want to say style is and then the value in that key, right? So that's how that works. Okay, so let's convert another label into an entry. Let's just make this an entry as well. And now I'm going to set this to is password. And that's true. So now we expect this to have a red background, right? And whenever I set the is password to false, then it should have a regular background. So again, no line of code, just some declarations in XAML. And you can see that this now shows the right styling. So does the hot reload work here? If I do false, and I save that, does that also apply it? Yes. So you can see the is password is false, and now it defaults to how it looks by default, right? So that's how to work with property triggers. I think this is really, really cool and really powerful. It's one of those features that is really easily overlooked, but you can do amazing stuff with this, right? You don't want to write code that is very much coupled to your UI, which is exactly what you need to do whenever you want to do these things based on interactions. Now, not anymore. If you are using XAML, you can easily apply these changes in appearance by just declaring some more XAML. And whenever you throw out this XAML and bring in some new one, you will automatically throw out these styles and bring in new ones, right? So there's no risk on forgetting something that is here and there. Now, I already mentioned there is also data triggers and multi-triggers and all kinds of triggers. So go to the next video right now, check out the data triggers, which is right here, and I'll see you in that one.